Hey guys, this is Leia from leiaforsci.com/MCAT, and today I want to talk to you about MCAT notes. The MCAT is a very big and very important exam, so you need to study well, and you need to study a lot. But this doesn't mean that you have to take a lot of notes. I have students that are so proud of how hard they study that they tell me about the binders and binders of MCAT notes for every single subject, which is great, but how many times do you actually go back to it? And that's when the answer gets a little dicey, because they don't. They don't because they have too many notes and they're terrified and overwhelmed by just how much they have to review. So the notes are great if you were able to go back to it and if you had the time. But if you don't, then why not reduce your study time by actually taking fewer notes, being more effective, and having notes that are so simple that it's not scary to go back. It's fast, it's easy, and you're looking forward to review. I discuss this in detail in the notes article linked below. But today I want to demonstrate how to simplify your notes when you're thinking that you have to write everything down. With permission, let's look at a few pages of notes from one of my MCAT students, where as we're looking at it, I want you to ask yourself, do I take similar notes? And if so, what of these tips can I apply to myself so that my notes are shorter, so that my note-taking time is faster, so that I progress through content more quickly? I want to show you that if you take notes like this, what you can look for to cut out of your notes, how you can simplify the information without sacrificing what you get, take less time writing it, take up less space so it's less overwhelming to study, and save time, because obviously the more you write, the more time it takes. First thing to recognize is her notes are very neat. Now, I'm not saying you should write messy, but if you're taking extra time to have beautiful notes, don't. No one's looking at them. It's just for you to jot down the few things that you need to go back to later that you can review and memorize down the line in case you forget, and that's it. A couple of tips. You don't want to write in full sentences. You don't even want to write in full fragments. You want to make your English professor cringe at your notes. That is how you should be writing. Use arrows and equal signs and diagrams rather than words, because they're simpler, they're shorter, and it takes up less space. So let's see. Let's see if we can cut out 5 to 10% of the notes. Starting with Lecture 1, Biological Molecules and Enzymes. Yes, definitely keep track of what it is. You can also write, for example, chapter X, page whatever, in case you want to reference your book. Or, as I suggest in the notes article linked below, you could just highlight directly on your book or take notes in the margins to simplify the process even more. I wouldn't necessarily break it down by section, because we're looking for just a few simple takeaways. In section 1.2, we have water is a solvent in which chemical reactions of living cells take place. Now, between you and me, when you're studying for the MCAT, there are certain things that you're going to have to write down that you're going to have to learn. But there are other things that, for the most part, we'll take for granted that you know. Something like this, that water is a solvent, you know this. So to take the time and write it down, it's not that you need to know it later. I would either skip that completely or just write water equals solvent and the rest is extra. Let's look at the characteristics of water. Again, you don't need a heading, because all you're looking for is a simple fact to memorize, other fact to memorize, other fact to memorize. You're not writing for the sake of writing. Polar molecules, unequal sharing. So instead of characteristics of water, you can just write H2O equals polar. Unequal sharing of electrons, that's fine. That's important. If you don't remember it, keep it. Next, we have hydrogen bonding. You can just as easily write it as H bonding, which is what she did here. You never want to write the same thing more than once because you assume you know what you're talking about. Hydrogen bonding, intermolecular bonding between H and NOF. Okay, we can say hydrogen bonding, intermolecular bonding, you don't need between H and NOF, that's fine. If this is not something you're comfortable with, you'd want to keep all of that. Because of hydrogen bonding, H2O molecules pull apart polar molecules, ions, and form, ordered networks around them. So we would kind of stop here. This is all talking about dissolving. So we would
maybe simplify that as hydrogen bonding allows ions or partial charges to dissolve. Just a simple short sentence. And then this just talks about solvating molecules, more of the same. So we get to the next bullet, hydrophilic. Likes H2O, that's the definition, so that's fine. Molecules or ionic compounds dissolve in H2O because negative charged ends attract to hydrogen. This is partial positive. Positive charged ends attract to oxygen, which is partial negative. That seems like a very long definition. So how can we simplify something like that? Hydrophilic likes H2O, and then just say positive to partial negative oxygen, negative to partial positive hydrogen. That's it. That's all you needed for this entire thing, and that gives you one more little piece of notes. Hydrogen bonding forms cohesive forces attractive between partial positive hydrogen and partial negative oxygen. This seems to be redundant. Cohesive forces occur between molecules of the same substance. I don't know that you need this definition, but if you did, you can just say between molecules of same. You're just trying to recognize what you wrote. Your English teacher should not be proud. Causes hydrophobic molecules to squeeze away from H2O and aggregate together. Hydrophobic molecules, we can just write scared. And if you want to use aggregate, just say, so they aggregate together. Increases boiling point and allows H2O to remain liquid state. So for something like that, instead of the word increases, just put an arrow. Up boiling point, H2O liquid. Just like that. A lot of energy is required to separate hydrogen bonding. This increases boiling point. That's a little bit redundant. So maybe you can make a note that higher boiling point requires higher temperature. Or higher boiling point requires more energy. We can keep going, but hopefully you see how so far everything here could have been written out as a couple of simple lines. And if this is what your notes look like, my goal is for you to save 5 to 10% of your note-taking time, because it's a little bit less time to write, less to review, and less overwhelming. But if you look at what we did here, we probably cut 50% of her notes, and we haven't really lost anything. If you feel that this is not enough, that you have to add something in, that's fine, but try to keep it as short and simple as possible. Let's go on for a little bit more on this. Water can be a reactant or product. You can write water equals reactant or product. You don't need anything else. I like equals and arrows because it saves so much time. If A goes to B, done. If something increases or decreases, less than, greater than, it makes the writing so much faster. Hydrolysis, macromolecules broken into two molecules through the addition of water. Well, we have hydrolysis. I would just write hydrolysis. So we're implying a macromolecule. We could just write molecule. Breaks in two by adding water or by adding H2O. Or how I would have done this is add H2O to break the molecule. Dehydration, two smaller molecules equals one macromolecule. H2O is a byproduct. So dehydration, we can say two small molecules yields one bigger, and you don't even need the word molecule, it's implied, plus H2O. H2O is a byproduct, plus H2O, shorter and faster.
So what do you think? Did this help you save at least 5 minutes off your study time by making your note-taking more effective? If yes, first, give this video a thumbs up, then let me know in the comments below. And if you'd like me to make more study tip videos like this, let me know what you'd like me to cover in the comments below.